AT&T Stadium. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Washington Redskins and the Dallas Cowboys. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Off as they run the counter play. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Against the Vikings, Matt Jones was inactive, so it looks like the Redskins are going to roll with Kelly for a while.
And that's not a bad thing. Coming out of Tulane, probably overlooked. Remember, he went undrafted, but was really impressive in the preseason this year. Not just in carrying the football, but in pass protection. Picked up the offense fast. And now they don't mind him being their lead ball carrier until they get Matt Jones healthy again.
Didn't disappoint in week 10, 97 yards.
And Reed with it over the middle. Give him seven on the play. And they're going to face a third down.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. Size, the hands.
Speed. Can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Cousins on third and two. He's got time in the pocket. And he's got his man in stride, complete. It'll be a 2 yard gain, and it'll be fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield.
It's taken to the 26. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. There comes the 11 on offense back onto the field for Dallas, and Ezekiel Elliott effusively praised his O-line after their Week 10 win, said, bottom line, I'm running behind the best O-line in the league.
And he's right, and they invested in this offensive line. Travis Frederick, the center, is a Pro Bowl guy, a first-round pick. Tyron Smith, left tackle, first-round pick. Zach Martin, right guard, first-round pick. No accident, they're all Pro Bowlers and all Pro players. But at left guard, Ronald Leary is playing awfully well, filling in for Lyle Collins, who many thought would be a first-round pick. And Doug Free is steady Eddie at right tackle. This unit is terrific. And when we talk about MVPs, these guys won't win it, but we should mention them.
Here's Prescott. Over the middle to Smith. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style where you actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position.
So the penalty by the offense, and now they face a first and 15. After the penalty, it's Elliott. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more.
Well, if you didn't know Ezekiel Elliott when he was at Ohio State, you know him by now in week 10 of the NFL.
And not only do you know him, you have to talk about him being a potential MVP. And I know that sounds crazy, a rookie running back, but boy, the way he has played and the numbers he's putting up, in addition to expanding his game, he had two catches in the last one for 95 yards a touchdown, one of them being 83 yards on the touchdown catch. He's doing everything for them, carrying the load. I think he sets the tone in a big way for the Dallas offense.
Yeah, two more on the ground against the Steelers in the end zone, including the game winner.
So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense.
Come on, let's go!
Now Prescott. He's got time. He completes it to Bryant. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for his tight end, Witten, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Cut it left. Cut it left. Four down, four down. Check.
Now let's go.
A first down throw for Cousins. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. You know, last week, Charles, I asked you about this Dallas defense. What do you make of them? 8-1, so much hype about the offense. Let's turn it defensive.
And they're a defense that really doesn't care about who gets the credit. And I know that's one of those great cliches, but they don't have that superstar that everyone just latches onto, except maybe Sean Lee, their linebacker, who I think is a marvelous player all over the field when he's out there. But also, in this game, as a return to the Pittsburgh area where he grew up, and grew up a Steelers fan. Had to be very sweet for him to take away a victory.
Exactly. Get to 8-1.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got this one just across midfield to the 49. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Let's go! Green 39!
Off the play fake, Cousins. And they're going to bring him down back across midfield at the 45. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
And the O-line will have to do a better job protecting here on third down after that sack. On third down, Cousins surveying the field. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27.
Thank you.
3 yards to go here on second down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
And the Redskins have an extra man in the secondary here on third. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Back deep here, Jamison Crowder. Crowder now to return. 12 yards on the return that time. And the offense will come back onto the field with a first and 10. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
To throw is Cousins. Complete to the right. This is Garcon. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And it'll be first down, Redskins. And quickly, they get to the line. Cousins now to throw on first down. Caught on the right side, Reed. And he's brought down after a good game. Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
From the red zone now, Cousins. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. A second down throw for Cousins. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
So a ways to go here on third and 10. They'll come out in the pistol. Cousins again. Looking for someone to throw to. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And Hopkins' kick is good. And it's 3-0 as the Redskins strike first. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
Following the made field goal for three, Hopkins now to kick it off. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. You know, I did want to ask you about the game you called this past weekend, Week 10. You had 15 punts in that contest between the Jets and Rams.
Lachlan Edwards for the Jets. The star of the day was Johnny Hecker for the Rams, averaged over 50 yards a punt, including a 78-yarder. And when you uncork a 78-yard punt, you should dance like their fellow punter, Marquette King of the Oakland Raiders. He dances like no one is watching.
Well, you made it sound like it was a great game. There's only one touchdown, three field goals.
Yeah, but 78 yards, got to give it up for that.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And they're just a couple of yards shy of a first down here on third down. It's a five-receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. Here's Prescott. And that's caught by Beasley. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Prescott. He's got time in the pocket. Drops it underneath. Elliott. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He's got time. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. Let's see if the defense tries any pressure here on third and eight. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. On third down, he'll drop to throw, finding time. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to loft one deep into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will be brought down. His time is now run out on this first half of action. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one taken just inside the 10. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
6 yards here to go for the offense on second down. They'll drop the throw. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them, make them think that you're doing something else, make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one.
They'll look to throw here, surveying the field, going right side here, and that's complete. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's got time in the pocket. He hits Beasley right side. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll bring up second down. Second down now after the pass completion. Here's Prescott. And Beasley with it over the middle. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right in midfield at the 50.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. And he'll get it up the middle. And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Play clock all the way to 0. Didn't get the snap off. 5-yard penalty.
And you see the head coach writing that note on his play sheet right now. He's going to be addressing that with his staff. A sense of urgency. Get to the line of scrimmage. Snap the ball.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Again, it's Elliott. They get 1 yard back there to make it 2nd and 14.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
Watch left, watch left, watch left. Stop right there, stop right there.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Going right side, he has Witten. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on 3rd and 10. Now Prescott. He completes it to Bryant. And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Back now in Arlington. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the 4th quarter. Throw now on first down. He's got time. Oh no, he lost the football. And the Redskins scoop it. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point
the kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash, dude.
Super toe.
Now a second down throw for Cousins. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. Call it a pickup of 7, and just like that, it's third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
The play fake. Cousins finding time. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cedric Thornton able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be fourth down. Here's Tressway now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? And he's brought down. Give him 11 yards and time and a new set of downs.
Gardner, I think that play echoed a short yardage run. I know they're backed against their own goal line, but when they stack the defensive line like that, if you find any type of a crease, you're up to the third level before you know it.
They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. They'll look to throw here on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Time starting to run out here in the fourth. This defense just trying to keep the offense off the board and preserve this potential victory. Here's Prescott. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ryan Kerrigan in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And this kick will be touched down as they spot it inside the 45-yard line. Again, we'll see the pistol here.
All right, here we go. 3-19!
They'll give it to him right up the gut. It'll be a minimum pickup, and it will take us to the 2-minute warning. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they went. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Third down, the Cowboys bringing an extra defensive back. They'll run with Thompson. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Here's Tressway now. He's been terrific so far. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Back to throw. Surveying the field. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Second down now after the incompletion. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They'll look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. And you would have to think an obvious passing situation here on third and nine.
Let's go! One, nine!
He'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Lance Dunbar is running back, the intended target. And that'll bring up a fourth down. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Come on, let's go! Round 38!
Back to throw. Complete to Jason Witten. And he's going to get this one all the way up to the 30. Give him 25 yards on the play there. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going. He's got time in the pocket. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. This is caught inside the 15. A big play here for Dallas. 58 yards. And now they're in the hurry-up. He's back to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll make it 2nd down. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Now Prescott. And he's got his man. It's Escobar. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now flags fly in, and one of the Cowboys looked like he got going a little early. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to potentially send us to overtime. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. On the return, this is Rashad Ross now. Oh, what a move. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So out now come the Redskins. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. In a tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that.
All right, here we go. Green 39, green 39.
Now Cousins. And Reed with it over the middle. And he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. Tie game, probably time for 1 final play here. What do you do in this spot?
Now you're thinking about Hail Mary. You've got to find a way to heave it all the way towards the end zone and give yourself a chance. Your time management sheet tells you with this amount left on the clock, you don't get cute and try and get 2 plays, because if you try that, that's all you're going to get is 1, and it won't be a 1 towards the end zone.
How will they handle it? Let's find out. 1 receiver left, 3 to the right. Here's Cousins. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's going to go down as time has now run out on this game. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick 6 or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
They go to Elliott again, and he will fight his way forward to about the 23-yard line. They'll get a couple yards back, but not more than that. They'll be left with 12 yards to go on third down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone, but these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Here's Prescott, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter on for a very important punt here in overtime. Now it's Crowder. Look at the spin.
Balance.
That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And the Redskins will take possession with a first and 10. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to him, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. An excellent job by the defense. Can the offense finish things off?
Yeah, part one is done, now part two. And Davis with it left side. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground.
Here we go now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think of run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
A gain of three, second down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
They'll run the option left. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. He lost four there, and it's third down. Will the defense dial up the pressure? Let's see. Third and 11. On third down, Cousins. This is caught by Jackson. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
And it's a fumble.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free.
but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. They come out here in the eye. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is in for the score! And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. As the fans exit back out through the turnstiles, not happy looks on their faces. Feel like they probably let this one slip away.